8,395 pounds. The old trusty 32 BHDS J flight here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This has become really the gold standard for these bathroom entry, outside kitchen, double slide bunkhouses. Big old living room, super slide. Slide out in the back for the kids so that on a rainy day, they're not gonna drive you crazy. And that's what I call mom and dad's sanity room. Now, despite its big size, because obviously this is she's a pretty good size coach, it's surprisingly accessible with the slides closed. Now, you're gonna have to do one or two of those sideways travel trailer shuffle steps, but you can get back here. You can open the bathroom door. You can get to this closet right here, and you can even get to the bunkhouse with the slides totally closed, which is something big units don't usually allow for. One of the nicer things about J flights, and man, that is not a short list of things, is their taller interior. And I think that's one of the things that's made them the best selling RV, not just travel trailer, but the best selling RV since 2005 and counting. That is a pretty impressive record. I don't believe it's ever been done in the business before, and I'd be shocked if it's ever accomplished again. These guys have remained the number one selling thing out there in the most competitive segment of the market. It's really impressive. So what are they doing that is so captivating to people? And the answer is a bunch of little things. Taller interior, 6'9" interior instead of 6'6", or 6'6" with a bubble vaulted roof, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with any other style of construction. It's just that this is that perfect better mix of space versus size versus weight versus amenity. It gives us a little bit taller slides. It gives us taller cabinets, taller bunks, a bigger shower, which is a really hot button issue for me when I go camping. There's definitely some things non-standard here. This is called the saddle decor. There's different decors available. This seems to be the most popular in our Jayco bunkhouses based on consumer feedback and purchase patterns. Right here, we've got a hide-a-bed trifold sleeper sofa upgrade. What I love is a little LED accent light below it, and you're going to find a couple of those in intelligent locations. But I like that they went with a clean, bright white light. There's nothing wrong with the blue LEDs I see in other things like your Cherokees, but I've heard some people say, man, it kind of looks like an old discotheque or something in here, and this just has a clean, brighter look to it. Now, our dinette over here can basically do anything. One of my favorite parts about this is how flexible that table is. Really, I don't know if they were the first ones, but Keystone really gave it a name, called it the Do More Dinette. And I love that it can float over and become a coffee table very easily in front of the sofa. And this floor plan's wide enough and won't block anything, but you could easily lift that table up on its elliptical base and make it like a craft time, utility time type table and leave the U-Dinette open as something like a lounge. Now, something else you'll find is full storage below this U-dinette, including some totes that slide open from under those bench end drawers right there. Now, for bonus sleeping, once again, you're going to be all kinds of covered here. It kind of starts with that bigger U-dinette, and that's the thing, is that this Jayco has a longer slide to accommodate both a longer 84-inch U-dinette, a full U-dinette, and a trifold sleeper sofa. The slide has to be bigger to accommodate both those things. Now, some little detail stuff, they softened up the interior decor just slightly compared to last season. I'm a fan of it. They're still fully trimming the windows, but they backed off on how dark the trimming was. They gave it more of a warm sort of cowboy cabin neutral feel. I'm all about it. I like what they did here. But the reason I like these trimmed out windows is it gives those pleated nightshades something to really bite into. But something else they did here, if you really want privacy, they made these like virtual blackout shades so that you can absolutely privatize this thing. Now, we do have a central air here, and although the one in stock could be different from what you see here, chances are, if it's one we have on hand, that's probably a 15,000 BTU air up there. The bigger AC compared to the standard unit, plus the thermal package available on these J flights, it just seems to make a heck of a difference. Now, that skylight we're looking at is also an optional piece of equipment we tend to put on our J flights. But especially due to the popularity of a couple of these J flights, like this model in particular, there's times where we run out. And I call my factory rep and I go, hey, man, whatever you got, I need it. So sometimes this model can come in a little wonky to us, but we try to make that known when they come through. The kitchen in the J-Flights is just fantastic. It starts with this stainless appliance bundle, but you may also notice that we've got a 33% larger 8 cubic foot fridge freezer here. Basically what that means in English, guys, is like 12 more Hungry Man dinners if you're trying to count sizing here. Now, because we have that taller ceiling, we have a taller pantry. We've got a 6'9" floor to ceiling pantry. And notice how they also don't waste space under the refrigerator. That is a common thing I see done in this business. It's always kind of drove me a little crazy. Big open space down here for a wastebasket, which is something a lot of campers still aren't necessarily nailing. And from the counter to the floors, this Jayco's got some drawers. They go all the way to the floor. But that's kind of the point. You don't really consciously recognize things like this a lot of times when you're RV shopping, but this is every day for Jayco. Even now in their SLX More base model series, they've done this. And tell me when more drawers is ever the wrong answer. Now, you'll also notice they're all plywood constructed, and they're beveled edges so you don't get splinters on the edge. And you are underlit under the kitchen counter here, kind of like under the sofa. The good news is those accent lights have individual switches you can kick off and on. Big shoe garage right by the entry door kind of helps cut the clutter. Notice how you've, in a way, almost got a big bonus pantry down here. Now, as we wrap around the countertop, you'll see that you can also get to that rear counter space very easily. So the section that's like kind of under or behind the sink, very simple and easy to get to. And again, that taller ceiling allows for greater overhead capacity with these pocket screwed cabinets. And they throw a shelf in there to double up on that greater capacity. As we keep progressing through the camper, here we have this central closet, pantry, linen cabinet, whatever you want it to be. Now, this is an access panel to things like your water heater for winterizing. That's why it's screwed shut on both sides so the kiddos can't get to it. But here we just have this big, like I said, bonus closet. You could do whatever you want with it. I've seen a lot of very creative storage solutions in here. But the bathroom is one of the things in a J-Flight I really, really like, and I think it's because of the taller shower, being a taller person. I don't wake up nicely in the mornings. I'm kind of mean. I'm kind of grumpy. You know, I like that taller shower. Now, a few things. Which switch is it? I always get the wrong one. There you go. Not terribly impressive during the day, but that little blue LED light at night is going to make this whole room kind of glow, especially the shower and anything white, which includes the toilet. So if the kids got to wake up at night to, you know, make a little potty trip or whatever, they're not going to wake everybody up. It's very easy to get through here. Porcelain bowl, foot flush stool, and as we swing around here, I'd like to point out the very large sink. It's actually got an adult size sink with plenty of cabinet space below for like toilet paper, toiletries, etc., extra things that you're going to want and need. Now over here, taller shower with that big skylight. But what's nice is even a tall person like me, you still don't even necessarily need the skylight. So if you're extra tall and you're like me and you just don't like to duck in the shower, this is the one. The J-Flight is definitely one of the brands that should be on your radar. Passing through here, we do have a sliding privacy door for the bunk room. So you can totally, totally close this off, which is very nice. Now I've got it set up in daytime mode right now. You can see that we've got this fold up upper bunk, and that's 300 pound rated, by the way. And you've got these J-Cube, Converticube sort of futon things. And I've had a lot of people, like previous years, people are like, oh, I love those things. Then all of a sudden last year, I heard a bunch of people ask if you could swap them out for a jackknife sofa because they thought the jackknife sofa was more flexible. I personally disagree. And maybe it's just differences in experience because these things can only become and do anything you want. Right now we've got them in a daytime lounge mode. But if you take a look here, you can see that these things can very easily, like the overhead bunk flips down and these lower cushion cube futon things, they fold right out into something probably rivaling a king bed, maybe slightly larger. So you can sleep, if you had to, two adults down here very comfortably. You could probably stack up the kiddos even deeper if you had to. But this bunk room does give us easy sleeping for four, maybe more, depending on how big they are. I love that rear window back here, too. That is something not a lot of bunk rooms have, or big windows for lots of airflow. But you find in a full-blown J-Flight, all the windows are going to open for ventilation. Now, up here, we have what I call the big kid bunk. It's about 50% wider. But another thing you're going to find through the Jayco's, I used to tell people that their bunk mats were 50% thicker than industry standard. But that's not really true anymore, because the industry standard got thinner. So Jayco's seem to have about double thickness bunk mats compared to anybody else out there. Very few exceptions, Rockwood being one of the others. But Rockwood's also a more premium brand who's not afraid to spend money on the smart things. But notice as I lift this up, you don't see what we've often referred to as beaver puke. Particle board, OSB, chipboard, whatever. The thing is, there's nothing necessarily wrong with that material. It's okay. There's good and there's better. And that's what this is. This is in that better category. They very recently, at the time of this filming anyway, kind of redesigned how this little bunk wall is arranged. And what I like here is they've got an extra little shoe garage down below that big linen cabinet. Jayco is still building their own, really heavy-duty ladders. So what's nice about this is they're even suited for, like, parental access to that upper bed or adult access instead of the little, it looks like, wooden spoke-type ladders that manufacturers can just buy. Those are fine. They'll save money. This is stronger, heavier-duty, going to last longer. Now, what you're going to find is in the, outside here in the bunk room, you got this little quick release TV mount. So if you decide to add a TV in here, you can very easily remove the TV, mount it outside, and maybe force the kids outside to watch their, SpongeBob, whatever. Can you believe SpongeBob? New episodes are still on the air. Anyway, sorry, tangents. Now, they purposely left these shelves down here open and accessible, but you'll notice that they also purposely left a nice little eyelet here to be able to run cables. So if you do let the kids bring some sort of entertainment electronic system, they're going to be able to plug those in. Another thing I like is the slide-out switch for the bunkhouse is actually back here. And it throws some people off because we've kind of become accustomed to everything being wired into that central control panel up front. The reason they do this, guys, is so that you have to stand right here. And you have to be able to see that slide open and close so you can make sure it will open and close without crushing anything, because we all know that the kiddos have a way of, like, leaving stuff lay around, and the last thing you want is Mr. G.I. Joe getting into your slide mechanism and getting ground up. I'm not really worried about the slide mechanism. I'm worried about the kid throwing that bawling fit because you tore up Snake Eyes and or what have you, My Little Pony. I don't know. I don't care. You get the idea. The point is, you don't want that. You don't want that bawling meltdown tantrum thing and where you feel just terrible as a parent, like, oh my god, I ruined their favorite toy. I feel like I'm a failure as a parent, you know. The point is, that slide button can eliminate that. That was a long explanation for a slide button, wasn't it? Wow. Okay, anyway, I don't script my material, obviously. Now, one nice thing is when this hide-a-bed is open, it will not cut off the camper. You still have about 12 to 18 inches to walk through there. So we already talked about the little shoe garage right by the door to cut down the clutter, but their entertainment center has recently upgraded. They've gone to a higher-grade chipset. It's still Bluetooth, DVD, stereo, three-zone speaker system. You got front, rear, and outside speakers, but you now also have streaming-friendly access. So those Chromecast, Roku sticks, etc., you can plug those in and have that USB-powered plug right there so that you can very easily stream whatever entertainment you're interested in here. Now, one thing I didn't mention in our kitchen tour previously, too, now that I'm looking, actually, first is the sealed edge thermal foil countertop. So, you know, this is a high water exposure area next to the sink. So they use a countertop that's been pressed and molded so that there's no T-mold and edge where water can seep and penetrate in there. Another thing, ladies and gentlemen, is that we've got a real tile backsplash, not that false wallpaper. And if you do the wedding ring test and tap on this faucet, you're going to hear metal clink back at you, not a nickel-looking plastic. So again, better materials. Now, one of the advantages of having wood studs in the walls versus a laminated trailer is it is very easy to install power outlets, household outlets, on the walls of a camper instead of on the bottom of cabinetry. I'm aware that appliances keep coming with shorter and shorter and shorter power cords. So having them down like that is much, much easier to get to. The bedroom does have sliding privacy doors. When those are both closed, the TV can spin around to face mom and dad. One of the nice things on the Jayco also is that the back of this TV is fully mirrored. So when those doors are closed and the bedroom is privatized, it feels bigger, even if the TV's not facing you, because you get the perception of greater negative space. Now, we talked about the skylight, but I do want to point out that if the sun is just baking you, you can close that. But notice how you can close it to keep the sun from cooking you, but they use a lighter material here than on the windows so that you still maintain some light. This is another little detail thing that's easy to miss. Jayco's air vents, they spend a couple cents more per air vent. Now multiply that by how many air vents they build in a year. They spend a lot of money on air vents. You can close them and you can turn them. And you can't usually do both in RVs. That's a very uncommon thing they've done here. Something else I want to point out, let me turn around here because this is another very easy to miss quality, is they use a really high-intensity light package in here, and that makes a difference. They spend more money on lighting. Lights and windows are very expensive in the RV business, and having more lights that are higher quality and more windows that also open for ventilation and are UV tinted, because you can't always bank on any of those things in this business, I think it's a big deal. That's one of the things I appreciate about this, but ladies and gentlemen, that is why the J-Flight is not the least expensive thing out there. Now, if you like this layout, and you like everything I'm telling you here, but dang it, if this big beast just isn't outside of your budget. Well, that's where something like the Cherokee 294BH comes in here at Haylett RV, which would be the Forest River rival to one of this. J-Flight being the number one selling trailer out there, and Cherokee being the number two. These two folks really got the job done very well. So the Cherokee will give you almost all the same equipment here as the J-Flight. It'll save you a little bit of money. It's not exactly the same. There's differences. There's a reason it's not the same budget. And if you need to get a little more budget conscious still, you can always also opt for the J-Flight SLX 324 BDS, which is basically just the simple series of this camper. Now right here, this is a big thing to point out. This is the full 80-inch queen bed. But not only that, they even left room at the foot of the bed. So if you've got really long legs or you still want to scoot around this bed to help make the bed or whatever, you still can do that. So sometimes you'll get a walk-around camp queen in a front bunkhouse like this, in the front of a bunkhouse rather, or you'll get the 80-inch bed but it pushes up against the wall. This gives you the benefits of both. We still have big side stands with household and USB outlets to, you know, run, charge, anything. We've got an easy lift bed deck here, double strutted for easy lift, and you'll notice even plywood construction under the bed where they're not expecting you to look necessarily, but they go all the way every time. Now we've already talked about a bunch of little things the J-Flight is doing differently. Maybe a little heavier duty construction here, there, the bunks or whatever, a little thicker material, better pocket screwed lumber core cabinets instead of stapled particle board stuff, you know. And all of those little things, like the plywood decking under the bed base, the fact that this has 5/8 tongue and groove plywood flooring and 3/8 tongue and groove plywood roof decking, which is virtually unheard of in this business, and especially in this market segment, those things kind of add up to help explain why this has twice the RV warranty, the full coverage actual RV warranty that covers like your appliances and all your expensive stuff out there, from virtually anything else. There's a lot of 3-year structural warranties out there, and they're great. They can be great. Like Keystone's is the most comprehensive out there. But there's a difference between a limited structural warranty and like a full RV warranty that goes twice as long as everyone else. And that's what you're getting here in the J-Flight. You know, it takes a lot of little things to get them there. So that's what I want to kind of focus on out here along the way as we go. Now you see that bigger, wider, and taller baggage door. And it's the same size on both sides of the camper all the way through and all the way under the bed. So you always maintain easy, easy access to the storage down there. Now they use an exceptionally large extended diamond plate on these big J-Flights. Basically any J-Flight with a slide out. And I kind of like that because it helps protect your frame, but it also sort of draws your eyes to the fact that we have an integrated A-frame here, which is also exceptionally uncommon in this business. So why am I pointing that out? Because every single Jayco, not just J-Flight, but all Jaycos ride on a custom engineered chassis. Every single frame that Jayco builds on top of is custom engineered specific to the load demands of this floor plan. The chassis manufacturer drives them nuts because they have to reset their lines every time they do it. But I think that, you know, you want a good house, you start with a good foundation, we're off to a good start here. Things like we've got 50% larger propane tanks And, you know, power awning, power tongue jack, a lot of campers have that. So I'm not going to spend a ton of time talking about that. We will look at the awning a little bit. What I do want to take a moment to zero in on, though, is the J-Flight thermal package, because it is the most in-depth and comprehensive heating, cooling protection package available within this class. So what it begins with, heating and enclosing the underbelly. And from there, it basically doubles the insulation in the floor. These have insulated slide floors. It has extra insulation through the roof. It actually also wraps around the nose. Very eerily similar to the way Jayco would insulate one of their fifth wheels. Now, I'm not telling you this is some Four Seasons camper. I really don't like that phrase anyway, because it really puts false expectations in a customer's mind. What I'm saying is, and the only reason I really don't say that's because this hasn't been tested. There's probably an above average chance this could actually pass, 0 to 100 degree, 24 hour testing, but they've never actually done it. So I'm not going to make false promises. I'm going to let you know what's there. And in this category, there is nothing with a better insulation package than a J-Flight with the thermal package added to it. Now, one of the things I like is between these slides, we have this almost like, I don't know, outdoor utility closet in a way, if you will. So we've got a, like 17.8 gallon per hour, just call it 18 for the sake of ease, 18 gallon per hour recharge hot water heater. It's a 6 gallon vessel, gas and electric powered, that can operate both simultaneously, and the gas side is auto ignition. Black tank utility flush, and this little outside shower with hot and cold water right next to your sewer area here. So God forbid you need some kind of easy cleanup, you're there. The other thing I kind of thought about, you could easily just sort of block off between those two slides and have like a little outdoor cowboy shower type thing if you need to hose the kids off if they've been in the lake before you let them into the camper. But that's where that direct entry bathroom door we'll talk about in a minute is going to get to. So we kind of talked a little bit about structure earlier, but I talked about the plywood roof and floor deck, and again, that's super, super uncommon. There are some campers that have gone to a plywood floor deck, but almost nothing has also gone to plywood roof decking. But what's also cool is even the basic J-Flight SLX series still has that. They go all the way every time. Again, I respect that out of them. Now, we have all LED tail and marker lighting here. Even luxury fifth wheels, the standard of the industry is still not LED tail and marker lights. I think that's just an exceptionally awesome thing. Also, it doesn't look like they've gone to it now, but it's one of those things I can't really see. In the very near future, these will have gone to the smart lighting system, which basically means that when you turn on a like the blinker on your car, all of the associated side marker lights and upper front and rear clearance lights will also blink along with that, so that other drivers know what you're doing. Like I said, it doesn't look like that's been implemented on this one yet. So if that's like a really, but granted, guys, this is the very first one of these for this model year that rolled in. So with the popularity of this one, by the time you take one home, chances are that's there. But I highly always encourage people to trust but verify. If that's an important item for you, call us. The good news, if it's not implemented on this trailer, it's also something you're not paying for. So you're never going to just get dinged. Those 3-year structural warranties, like I said, they can be cool, but they're also very easy to void. What if you just want to take along bikes on a bunkhouse like this, but it doesn't have a bike rack on the back? You're thinking, oh, I can just throw them on the bumper or something, right? Not if you want to keep your structural warranty. You'll void that. You're not supposed to be strapping stuff to the ladder either, so scratch that off. A lot of people don't want to put bikes in the camper because, you know, the tires, the oils from the tires can leave stains on the RV floor, which kind of look like cigarette burns, which kind of hurt your resale. And you get the idea. Now, that receiver hitch on the back of this is an optional piece of equipment, but we do like to put it on basically all of our bunkhouses here, so that if you choose to add a bike rack or something, you have the dedicated place for it without voiding your structural warranty. Your outside kitchen here is fantastic. It's simple, but it's simply effective. They really kind of came up with this outside kitchen a long time ago, and it just keeps working. It's like a crocodile. It doesn't have to evolve because it just came out right the first time, I guess. So you see out here, even plywood box drawers out here, to give you plenty of room for like spatulas and whatnot. Now, there's two propane hookups here. There's one that runs to the back if you feel like you want a different grill sort of setup, but there's also one dedicated for this little cooktop right here. Although you can see it's got a stainless top on it. You could just use that for counter prep space if you want. And if you're not using it, congratulations, it's out of the way. But it does open up this nice big chunk of countertop space right here. So this is really large. If you want to bring appliances out here, a microwave even, you've got household plugs to do all that or run phone chargers. And even out here, just like inside, overhead cabinet doors that flip up and down, they will actually be strutted to hold themselves open. And we don't just have Dad's medicine cabinet out here. We've got the Super Bowl XL version, you know, the bigger outside refrigerator to give us max capacity here. Now, throw some people off to be able to stand outside of the camper and see the toilet. Less so now, as this feature has become more and more common and more sought after in the business, but this has become a make or break thing for some folks. Having direct bathroom access, it cuts down on so much dirt and foot traffic going through the camper. It's just not even funny. I know my brother used to go catfishing when we were growing up, and he had these just disgusting smelly shoes, but the bunks were on the opposite side of the camper from the door. So he just stomped through the whole camper and left his catfish smelling shoes everywhere. Now you don't have that here. And in case you're concerned about privacy, I understand. The good news is there is a deadbolt here for the door. Now notice too, they made it so the bathroom door wouldn't smash the awning. Isn't that smart? So, two things on this awning. Three maybe? I don't know. Four. It's big. One. It's got LED lighting all the way across. Two. It's easy tilt. Literally two fingers can tilt this thing. So there's three. And your speakers outside are built right into the awning arm heads up here. And that might seem a little gimmicky or weird to some folks. But guys, what it means is there's not a pair of 4-inch holes drilled through your wall, which in theory could be a leak point. Now there's a difference between theory and practice. We've never had that be a problem on our J flights. But now I have 100% guarantee we won't have that problem on our J flights. Little extra things they do on Jayco. This is not normal industry stuff. If you look around, look real close if you're shopping around and walking around other RV lots. You see that extra sealant on top of this marker light right here, how it's top sealed? That's not industry standard business as usual stuff. That's extra stuff Jayco's done here. So it's extra little things that help contribute to that warranty. And this is a big thing. This isn't just best in class, this is best in industry. Goodyear Endurance radial tires. Rated for up to 87 mile per hour. These are the best tires used in the towable RV industry. There are, I mean, even a lot of fifth wheels still aren't using these. And Jayco uses Goodyear Endurance radials across the board, which is nice. Now, this is that matching TV bracket I mentioned in the bunkhouse. So if you do add a TV onto this thing, it can easily float right around. And I have to look. They recently changed their hardware for the main living room TV. It's also a quick release. That living room TV may be able to float out here now and hook up to that. A wider 30-inch entry door kind of rounds out the package. There is a simple solar prep plug right on the tongue here. So if you are looking for those solar panels, you're good to go there. I think we pretty much covered her at ground level. Let's take a climb up that rear ladder and see what she looks like up top. So you can't really, you know, see it up here because everything's finished. But even the way they handle their roofing is a little bit different on J-Flight from what you find in a lot of the industry. There are some brands that do something similar. To save time in production, what some brands have for the adhesive, the glue that's holding the roof membrane liner down right now, they have like a mist sprayer, basically, and they just spray all over the place. But you know what they don't want to do with that glue? They don't want to overspray off the side of the trailer and get that stuff on the sidewalls, because good luck cleaning it off. So the guy tends to not really glue very much next to the side of the trailer. Well, you don't have that at J-Flight. They pour it through, and they actually take rollers, and they give it 100% coverage so that there is even application all the way across this thing. Now, we're also on Tug and Groove plywood floor decking with their Magnum Truss roof system. And what that means is that we've got like a, 4,800 pound rated roof. It's ridiculous. Now, you see this big, beautiful Jayco Eagle over here. These things can be $50,000, $60,000. Exact same roof structure as this. This J-Flight uses the same construction methodology as an Eagle, basically same as a North Point and a Pinnacle. The only difference there is they have double arched roof trusses. But these, they have the same effective like load rating. I can walk all over this, as you see, as I'm walking around. This is the antenna right here. You don't have to crank it up and down. But it's not one of those omnidirectional antennas. Omnidirectional antennas are nice because you don't have to aim them, but they don't get very good range. So this gives you superior range and reception, but you do have to aim it. But who cares? You don't have to crank it down. Now, you can add a second AC to these if you upgrade to 50 amp service. Here in the Midwest, we don't find a lot of need for that. Even with the 15,000 BTU package and the thermal package on the air conditioner, well, pardon me, 15K air plus thermal package, it seems to get the job done more often than not. So you can see they use a real heavy application, nice even application of all their sealants and whatnot. There's a reason. These guys have been the number one since 05 and counting. They've become the gold standard in this business. Laminated trailer brands have to, like, they're always researching what's J-Flight doing next so they can try to keep up. It's really interesting how amazingly impactful these guys are. But, you know, with all the different brands and all the different things here we carry at Halet RV, that's the kind of stuff that we're in tune with. So if you're kind of interested in finding the one that really just fits you the best, we've only got about 20 acres of 450 to 500 campers here that'll take care of you. So give us a call, whether it's hitching, pieces, parts, trades, financing, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything in between, with the exception of hidden dealer fees. We don't do that because hidden dealer fees are garbage. Give us a call. 800-256-5196. We're Halet RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.